Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In one of my previous videos, I showed you how we can use Wokwi Simulator to simulate our IoT projects using different microcontrollers such as ESP32, Pi Pico, Arduino, and there are many other options. But using Wokwi in a browser has some limitations. Let me show you. For example, let's click on this ESP32 and let's click on this ESP32 HTTP server. So you see there are a few instructions. If I will run this, I get this IP address, and if I will open that, it should open a web server, but we cannot open a web server. To use the web server, we will need the Wokwi IoT gateway, and to use that we have the instructions here. One of the thing that I would like to mention is that the private gateway is only available for users to join the Wokwi club, and the Wokwi club is not free. You will have to pay a subscription fee. But there is another way to do this and to use the ESP32 web server locally, and that option is we can use the Wokwi in VS Code. So let's see how we can use Wokwi in VS Code. So the first thing that we need to do is I will search for Wokwi VS Code, and here are the instructions. Firstly, we will need a Wokwi for VS Code extension. So we will go in our VS Code and we will go to this extension tab here. I will search for Wokwi and you will be able to find a Wokwi simulator here. So I will install this. Okay, so it is already installed. I have been using the Wokwi simulator for a long time on this system. That's why it didn't ask me for a license, but if you will be installing it for the first time, it might ask you for the license. The license will look something like this. You will see a tab like this. Do you want code to open the external website? In that case, press open and you can click here, get your license. But for that, you will have to log in the Wokwi simulator. So I will click on get your license and license activated. I will open Visual Studio Code. So and then I will click on open and our license has been activated. The next thing that we are going to do is we are going to run the HTTP web server on Wokwi simulator in our VS Code, and we want to access it locally. So I'll go back to this get started page, and here are few example projects that we can try. I will try this one, ESP32 web server. I will be needing this code, so I will go here. I will copy the URL of this Git repository. I will come back to this VS Code. We'll go to Explorer. In the terminal, I will open a new terminal and I will write git clone, and I will get this repository. But for this, you will need to have Git installed in your VS Code or in your system. Or the other way is to download the zip file from the GitHub by clicking here and pasting it in the folder. So let's enter this, and you can see that the repository has been cloned. And we see several files, and let's see this diagram.json, and you see there are two LEDs that will be controlled using the local HTTP web server. Furthermore, we see this PlatformIO.ini file, which is for the PlatformIO configuration, and in that we are defining the platform, which is Espressif32, framework is Arduino since we are using the Arduino framework, and board is ESP32 development kit. To build this code, we will need the PlatformIO extension, so I will install it. I will search for PlatformIO and I will simply click on install, and you see it is installed now, and we can see a PlatformIO icon here. So now we are going to build our project, but Before building, let's go through the some configuration files. So we have this wokwi.toml. In this file, we are defining the version of Wokwi, and we are defining the firmware file path, which will be in this path after building. And this is the most important part. In we are just forwarding the localhost 8180 port to port 80 on this simulated ESP32. So let me show you the code. This is our code, which is similar to the code that I showed you in the Wokwi simulator in the browser. And we see the web server will be accessible at port 80, but here we are forwarding it to port localhost 8180. So we will be able to access the web server on our localhost. Then I will go back to this platform IO. I will pick a folder and I will select the folder. So the project has been opened. Now in the platform, we will go back to the platform IO, and here we will see several options: build, upload, monitor. So we are simply going to build this. It will take some time, and after the image has been created, you can go back to your explorer and you will be able to find the build file here, firmware.bin and firmware.elf. So these are the files which we mentioned in the wokwi.toml file. Now to run this, we will press F1, and you will see the several options here. You can type Wokwi start simulator, and it's running. So now you can see the IP address, which is the IP address of the ESP32 in a simulated version, and then we have the web server which has started on this URL. So we will open this, and you see the web server here. So now let's test this. I will click on LED. So LED is on, LED 2 is on as well, off, LED 2 is off as well. So it works. Another advantage of using Wokwi in VS Code is that in some cases, for example, if we are simulating our code in Wokwi simulator in browser, we face some problems while building the code. For example, if your code is very large, it takes a lot of time to build and to simulate. But if you will try it on VS Code, it is comparatively faster and it's really easy to manage. The other advantage that I find using Wokwi in VS Code is that using the platform IO, because it helps you define the libraries. For example, if you are using some libraries that are not available in the Wokwi simulator in browser, you will have to get the Wokwi club in order to upload a new library. But here it's really simple. For example, you can add this option lib_deps equal to, and you can just simply give the GitHub URL of that library, and when you will build it, platform IO will extract that library and will add it to your project. So these are some of the advantages, and I have been using it for a long time, and it is really helpful for building or simulating your IoT projects. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe for more such videos, and if you have any question, please feel free to ask in the comments.